What do we have here? I don't recognize any of those players in the enemy team. I don't recognize any of those players. There's some kind of a team NJ. I don't recognize it. Interesting. Hey boys, any chance we can first pick tank and heal? Very nice if we don't show our assassins and so later early in the draft. Okay, we have a healer guy. Wall Master Rager main. We have Wall Master Diablo tank. Okay, good. This Jaina is a Wall Master Jaina main. I wanna see his Jaina win rate. 85, pretty good. Last pick, Bloodku. Average Master Hanzo main. Hanzo win rate, didn't play. Interesting. I'm gonna ban Kira as a first ban. Our three picks are nice. Jaina, Ragnaros, and Chromie. But we don't want to log them this early, so we don't get countered. Any chance Joe and Woodpool can walk tank in here? I'm gonna ban HC here. What's the point threshold to get GM? I have no idea for Ferromania because GM leaderboard is still not up. It's gonna be up next Wednesday. So, you know, there is no way for to know for sure. Because the GM border is created when you have 100 people in GM. And the lowest person in GM is the border, so. Well, I didn't manage to make it to Grandmaster last season. Mainly because I got placed Platinum 1 last season. And I just didn't have enough time to grind it up. But I finished with 10.8, 55% win rate, which in my opinion is pretty decent from Platinum 1, man. We did get GM in every other season in Hero League. Rank 15, rank 137, rank 125, rank 43, rank 4, by the way, PogChamp. And yeah, just sometimes you don't get that lucky, man, with teammates. It is what it is. Anyway, Ragnaros, I don't mind Ragnaros here. They did get a lot of good picks though, Vava and Chen. What do we wanna ban here? I'm just gonna ban Ana because she's an annoying healer overall. But, yeah. How many points do you predict? I actually predict that the lower border at the start of the season is gonna be 5,000. I don't think it's gonna be that high, in my opinion. I think it's gonna be 5,000 at the start, and then it's gonna get pretty high up quickly, because everyone is gonna try to go for it. Yo, what's up, Bad Itchy, man? Nice deal. Who were you in the last match? I do remember your name, but I forgot who you were. You're definitely not the Stitches. You must be the Gul'dan, I think. Who were you? I don't think I'll be able to get GM1, man. I also don't really wanna pick Chromie here. Maybe Faustad. Okay, Diablo, Jaina, pretty good. Boys, I'm not gonna lie. I really like Zeratul here. Because we can go for the old Apocalypse Circle combo. Even Ragnahammer. Problem is, we are a lot of melee. I think I can land a good VP into Malfurion at least. Do you wanna try it out or too greedy? Might be too greedy to go 0-2 here. Might be too greedy to go. Alright. I serve. I actually think 0-2 is a very bad pick here. You can't really kill Chen. Tracer is way too mobile. Johanna can block you. Vava is way too bursty. And no, let's see what we can do though. Generally, Zeratul is in a bit of a weak spot at the moment. But man, I don't know if you boys knew, but the first hero I ever mained in Heroes of the Storm was Zeratul. Doc Cliff built VP0 back in the day with Grim Task. I don't know if you remember Grim Task. Grim Task was a talent that gave you 5% spell power per kill to a total of 50% extra spell power, but you lost all stacks on that. I mained Grim Task Zerato. But those were the good old days, man. Anyway. Oh, you were the Gul'dan. Yeah, I guessed you right, man. I know. That was a very nice fear on top of the crater, but I really like the fear there. Very good job, man. Alright, we're gonna play an auto-attack build, definitely. Because I feel like Cliff build at the moment is in a bit of a weak spot. I think Cliff build is in a bit of a weak spot. We're gonna go for an auto-attack build with double Vorpal Blade. But we're definitely gonna go Void Prison so we can combo. I'm gonna call out some things for my team. Alright. Here's what ults and how you're gonna use them. Jaina, you don't take circle. Water elemental is very valuable into Tracer. I'm gonna go Shadowhunter for now. I just need Apocalypse and Ragnaros. Take your main ult. If you play Lava Wave, that's fine. But you can also go Hammer for VP. Don't overextend all woods for VP. We might fail it. Water Elemental for safe lane mapping. I want a Ragna on the... Okay, you're going top. Good. Just kill Vala? Yeah, sure, man. Kill Vala and Chen, when Chen jumps on, back on you. Low. Alright, let's see what I can do here. I'm gonna damage the trade. Oh, I got rooted. Let's back away. That was a very good Malfurion root. I need to play it a bit safer, man. I need to play it a bit safer. I haven't played 0-2 from a long time. Especially since the change of the meta. And I'm a bit not practiced. I'm a bit not practiced and I might fail. So cut me some slack if I'm playing bad boys. I'm gonna do my best. Oh, there's the Tracer. I knew she would try to gank top. Let's just stay here for now. Let's see if Chain is gonna overextend. He did get a Fountain. I'm gonna ping my team on the bottom to back away. Chain is playing way too passive here. There is the Tracer. That was a nice thing for Ragnaros, but I'm just mainly gonna try to follow Tracer for now. She's missing. Let's go back to bottom so we get some stuck of heals. I'm really afraid of Pulse Bomb at the moment, so I need to be careful. Thank you for the heal, mate. Going on Johanna. We did get the singularity spike. Tracer is still pretty healthy. Another good stuck of heal. Let's see if we can capture Tracer on the rotation here. I'm gonna wait for her in this bush. Yeah, she's coming. She might have Pulse Bomb, but we did land in most of our damage now. Oh, she blinked away. I might die to Chain here. That was a very nice blink away. Well played, man. I needed some awareness from you, Ragna. So you can help me sooner. I was chasing Tracer. Chain put me up. It is what it is, man. I did learn some a valuable lesson though from this outcome. The valuable lesson is, by the way, I'm actually gonna go for the auto attack talent, so we have a better race as well with the auto attacks. Valuable lesson is, I might wanna save Vorpal Blade for Tracer when she blinks away. Ragna is gonna die. So I have an instant teleport on her blink away point. So I might consider doing that. Also, what I really need to do is farm some health globes so I can complete my blink quest. My blink quest can really help me out. And at the moment it's very low. And I'm not happy about that. I'm also pretty low on the HP, so I can't really help my team much. I'm just gonna defend for now. Let's get some heals here, boys. Thank you. We're a bit low on the race. They have a pretty strong race with Vala. We might want to consider fighting, but we could also try to race it down. I guess he's gonna be fight for now on the defense. We have a mercenary camp pushing for bottom as well, which is cool. I'm getting poked. We landed a single arty on the tracer. I didn't put a Vorpal Blade on the tracer there, unfortunately. I just go race it with 0-2 auto attack speed, honestly. I'm being a bit useless anyway at the moment, so might just well land some auto attacks. I just hope my team is fine. I'm gonna be watching them. My team needs help now. Oh boy. We lost this guy way too fast. There. Yeah. Feels bad, man. We lost Tukov way too fast. Oh well. Unfortunate. Save Vorpal, save Vorpal. Taking a lot of damage. Did someone send me an invite or something? A friend request? Strange. Alright, Ragnaros. I mean, to be fair, Ragnaros should Molten Core on the top, so I'll go. I'll go bottom, soak into chin. Alright, one thing that we're doing bad here is we're not really completing this quest. And I'm not happy about that. Miss. Yeah, we're playing 0-2 a bit bad at the moment. What? Ragna. Molten Core top. Why not Molten Core Ragna? That was a wasted. Ragna just fucked up the entire rotation. Why wouldn't he Molten Core on the top there? That doesn't make any sense. Well, we got it at least, but. I think Ragnaros is doing some bad mistakes, which I'm not happy about. Yeah, I'm not happy about this Ragnaros decision, man. What? I mean, one of the real good uses for a Ragnaros on Immortal on Battlefield of Eternity is soaking some of that Immortal damage with the Molten Core. Nice kill, by the way. So, I really don't understand why he wouldn't wanna prioritize that value and just move towards a lane that is already soaked by me. That doesn't seem logical for someone in Master, in my opinion. It is what it is, man. Let's just soak top for now. And see what we can do. I might start the top camp. Yeah, because I feel like my team might be dying there until I come. So let's just start this camp instead. My team is doing some trades, so that's kind of cool, but yeah. Most of them did die there. We're definitely going to Void Prison this game. We have a lot of potential combos. If we land a good prison on Malfurion and Vava, we should be able to follow up with the rest of the team. I'm not really that good of a Might of the Nerazim player. Especially since I know that I'm probably going to die very quickly into a Malfurion Silence and Vava and Tracer damage. So I'm going to prioritize going for a hard engage with my team's ultimates. And work within the chaos itself. Okay. Both teams are gonna get level 10. Good, VP is up. We have Hammer. It's actually a bit hard to combo Void Prison with Hammer, because Hammer's trigger animation is a bit quicker. But it's still possible. Chain going on me. I'm gonna blink away, so I'm a bit more defensive. I'm gonna VP right there. Send the ult. Apocalypse, bam. On the chain. Chain is gonna die. Oh, he's staggering the damage, but he's dead anyway. Malfurion Silence, the Tracer Bomb going in, we're taking a lot of damage. Let's try to prioritize a squishy hero here if possible. Stukov heal, let's prioritize the Immortal now. That was a good VP combo, man, I really enjoyed it. But I feel like we couldn't manage to kill enough people there. Alright, I'm gonna move to soak the bottom mercenary there. Another 5v5 is gonna be forced. Let's try to keep the pressure on Tracer if we can. Yeah, we have double Vorpal for that. Oh! That's too close, man. Too close for both of us there. Holy shit. That was scary. I need to recall ASAP, man. I really need to complete my Glob quest, man, so I have a bit more blinks. We lost the Immortal. God damn it, man. God damn it. We lost the Immortal again. VP in 20, that's not good enough time. Chain is... Let's keep pressure on the Tracer again. She's pretty far away though. Mofiren in a bad spot. Ah, he has the blind! Ah, fucking blind, man! Alright. Well played by Johanna. That's a nice breakdown. Alright, Arkane killed a lot of good dudes there, so that's cool. I really need to complete this Glob quest, man. I really need to complete it. Level 13. I mean, generally wanna go for the Mendic Strikes because I'm going for a Master Warblade build. But I'm wondering if it's gonna be worth it versus a Blind. I generally also like Spell Shoot into a Tracer Bomb, but I feel like we can get a lot of self-sustain with Mendic Strikes as well. Potentially if I wanna like force 1v1 into a Chen on the solo lane, that could also be a good moment for Mending Strikes. So I'm gonna go Mending Strikes, but I need to be careful with not overextending. Right, my team got the camp. Be careful boys, you're outnumbered and I'm not still there. I'm just trying to soak level 13 for us, but you're kinda pressuring me to come a bit sooner here. Ragnaros is not on top. Let's just stay here for vision. I don't wanna engage without Ragnaros. Ragna, come bottom, Ragna. Come, Ragna. Man, if you wanted to do that, I could have just soaked the top instead of you, man. Come on. Alright, I'm just gonna stay with the Diablo here. He's took off in a bit of a bad spot. I don't wanna engage yet. I'm gonna wait for Ragnaros. Root, Diablo. Oh! I couldn't warp. Oh, we got him though! Holy shit! The singularity damage. Nice. We could actually force push here. Yeah, if we kill the gate, I can go for a VP, man. Bam. Oh, he died. Nice. Fantastic combo, man. I'm a bit low on the HP to continue hunting here, though. But it should be... I could blink on Mofiren if I'm not that much of a pussy. I just play Immortal and top, though. No, don't invade there. Go Immortal. I'll de-push it. Quest complete finally. Holy shit. So, now that we have quest complete, we can go aggressive with a blink. And then use our Vorpals to chase. Oh, team fighting is happening here. What the fuck? I didn't even notice that. Ah, I couldn't kill him. We're losing everyone. We lost everyone there. Holy shit. What the fuck, man? I'm probably dead. Okay, we got Johanna real quick. That was very scary. I don't know how our team throw that advantage. It was literally 4v4. Strange, man. I'm just gonna soak a bit until most of my teammates respawn. And then I'm gonna be looking for a fight. Ragnaros a bit low. Oh, he got... Diablo got a kill there. Fantastic, man. Fantastic stuff. Let's kill this catapult. Alright. Now we can force a fight with Void Prison available. I'm gonna be looking for Vala here. Vala or Mofiren. Let's do some race in the meantime, though. Diablo is zoning. Good. I would kind of want to force the Immortal before they respawn, though. Or avoid prison engage. One of the two. This is a bad place for us to fight. Let's look for avoid prison engage from the top side here. Chain. I'm just gonna damage. VP on everyone there. Apocalypse now. And the Ragnaros ultimate. Fantastic combo. That's how we do it. Vorpal for the end. And GG, man. Hey, the old Zeratu is back, boys. Look, now we have Master Warblade, so we should be easy to 1v1 pretty much anyone. I'm just gonna de-push that real quick. If Chen wants to contest me, that's fine. I'll come top soon, boys, don't worry. Thank you, Fefero. Alright, chain 1v1, let's do it, man. I have Master Warblade. I'm missing the auto-attacks, but that's fine. We still can auto-attack her. Oh, yeah, no. I couldn't click my Vorpal Blade there. I was gonna kill him with Vorpal Blade, but the duration ended. That's why you saw me throwing W and Q here. Because I thought that Zeratul was gonna blink on top of Chen and I used my cooldowns on top of him. But for some reason the Vorpal didn't connect there. Alright. It is what it is. Should be able to chase him down, in my opinion. Gonna be hard though. Okay, Void Prison in 10, we should help our team to maybe end the game there. That was a nice jump on the wall there, by the way, from him. Stukov, a bit of a tough spot. Alright, we're here for the team. Immortal is pretty healthy. Let's see if we can do an engage here. I couldn't put the Vorpal on the Tracer. We can just go core, honestly. Apocalypse. Bam. Fantastic. Blink away so I don't die. We got the Johanna. Core is doing pretty low as well. Let's get one Stukov heal. I couldn't get the heal. I don't want to overextend without a heal, man. Damn. I'm gonna die here. The multi-shot revealed me and I just got unlucky for the Stukov heal. Why didn't the heal jump on me there? I was close to them. Come on. That's so unlucky. Alright, dude. I'm really not getting good heals this game, man. So actually, I'm just gonna go Shadow Mending, man. Like, usually... Root for minus skilling. I shouldn't be able to get caught by Root. Usually, you don't wanna go Shadow Mending with an auto-attack talent. Usually, you wanna go for Nexus Blades. But man, I really need some extra heal sustain, man. Like, this is ridiculous. If I miss something like a blink or anything else, I just get screwed because I just cannot survive much. At least we're winning pretty good here. Ragnaros, don't overextend there. Ragnaros, back away. I'm just going to push. Yeah, they're engaging him. I'm going to push this trio quickly and then join my team. Go play, they kill the Tracer. Good. Actually, I can backdoor core. Or a 1v1 chain here. Let's try to do that. Until my team is doing stuff, I'm gonna check on chain top first. He's not there. I just tried to stock level 20 a bit. My team doing a lot of good kills though. Very good stuff. We don't wanna go immortal for now. We kinda wanna push top though. Bottom. Why wouldn't you push bottom? I'm just gonna sock 20. If they wanna play it slow, I'll play it slow with sock top. Sock top, yeah. Let's get this mercenary as well. For level 20. Okay, good. Level 20 should be very soon. And the top is being pressured. We just need to land a good VP now. Because their team is overextending. I'm looking for the VP. There it is. I need Apocalypse now. Bam, on the Vala. Fantastic. Blink on him, back up. Another blink, and this is how we do it, Pro Zeratul, boy. This is how we Pro Zeratul it. Woo! Baby! Vorpal soon. I can't overextend on the towers. I could still go on him, though. I just cannot get hit by the towers there. Finally, a Stukov heal. Wow. Wow, Izawi. Wow, we actually played a good Zeratul, boys. Can you believe it? Fantastic stuff, man. I'll be absolutely honest with you. Zeratul was very bad in this draft. The only reason Zeratul was somewhat good here is because we could combo Apocalypse. On theory, on theory, Zeratul with Vorpal Blade is very good into Atreid, Serval and Malfurion. But as you saw, their team would always turn very quickly against me and burn me down quickly. That's why I knew that Zeratul wasn't a good pick here, because I knew that their composition was favorable to turn against me quickly and burn me down. That's why I tried to just play it as safe as possible, wait for kills to be created, wait for their team to get stunned, and then I would go in and do my thing.